Good morning students. In the last lecture we have studied regarding electrode concentration cells. In today's lecture we will continue our discussion with electrolyte concentration cells. So first of all we will talk about electrolyte concentration cells without transference. In these type of cells, two identical electrodes, they are immersed in the same electrolyte having different concentration. As these are electrolyte concentration cells, so the concentration of electrolyte will be different in the two electrodes, in the two half cells, and this can be achieved by two ways. Electrolyte concentration cells without transference, they can be achieved in two ways, by connecting the two electrolytes by salt press. Second way is by combining the two cells. As the two electrolytic solution, they are not in direct contact with each other, therefore the transference of ion from the one solution to the other solution doesn't take place directly. It is not taking place directly, that's why we are calling them as electrolyte concentration cells without transference. Why the name electrolyte? As a difference in the concentration of electrolyte. Why we are calling them as concentration cell? Because of difference in the concentration, the EMF is arising. And why we are calling them as without transference? The reason being, the two electrolyte solution, they are not in direct contact with each other. Now first one, by connecting the two electrolytes by salt bridge, we are getting electrolyte concentration cell without transference. So there are further two types of cells under this category. First one is when both the electrodes are the gas electrodes dipped in electrolyte solutions of different concentrations. Second type is when the two electrodes are metal rods dipped in the solutions having different concentration. So first we are taking the example of gas electrode. In this case we are having at one side hydrogen at pressure 1 atmosphere, which is in contact with the hydrogen ion at activity A1. In the other side we are having hydrogen at 1 atmosphere pressure with the contact with the hydrogen ion in the solution having activity A2, and these two half cells are connected through the salt bridge. Now oxidation reaction is taking at left hand side, so hydrogen gas is releasing electron to give hydrogen ion, whereas reduction reaction is taking at right hand side, so hydrogen ion are taking up the electrons to convert to the hydrogen gas. So adding both the reaction, we are getting the overall reaction, where H plus of activity A2 is moving to H plus of activity A1. So what does it mean? On passes of 1 Faraday of electricity passing through the cell, there is overall change of transfer of 1 mole of hydrogen ion from solution having activity A2 to the solution having activity A1. So this is the net overall reaction taking place in this concentration cell. Now the electrode potential at LHS at left hand side, which we are getting by using the Nernst equation, applying the Nernst equation to the oxidation half cell reaction, we are getting the electrode potential is equal to standard electrode potential plus RT by NF log natural A1. N is equal to 1 here. Now the activity of hydrogen is taken as 1, as the gas is at 1 atmosphere pressure. So we are considering the activity of ion only here. Now the standard electrode potential of hydrogen electrode is taken as 0. So we are putting the value 0 in this equation. And finally we are come up with the electrode potential E1 is equal to RT by F log natural A1. Similarly, applying Nernst equation to the right hand side, we are getting E2 electrode potential is equal to RT by F log natural A2. Now the net EMF of the cell will be obtained by ERHS minus ELHS, or you can write E cathode minus E anode. So we are getting net EMF of the cell is equal to RT by F log natural A2 by A1. Now considering another type in which we are having जिंक रोड विच इज इन डिप्ड इन द जिंक आयन ऑफ एक्टिविटी A1 एंड दिस इज कनेक्टेड थ्रू द साल्ट ब्रिज टू द अनदर सेल इन विच वी आर हैविंग जिंक रोड कनेक्टेड टू द जिंक 2+ आयन हैविंग एक्टिविटी A2. These two half cells are connected through the salt bridge. Now the oxidation reaction taking place at left hand side, zinc is releasing 2 electrons to give zinc 2+ ion. Reduction reaction is taking at right hand side. So zinc 2+ ion are taking up 2 electrons to convert to zinc. So the overall reaction is zinc 2+ of activity A2 are converting to zinc 2+ A1. Means there is transference of 1 mole of zinc 2+ ion from the solution of activity A2 to the solution of activity A1. Again, writing the EMF of the cell, that will be equal to ERHS minus ELHS. Now, we can replace the activity of the ions by the product of their molalities and activity coefficient by using these relation. Putting A1 is equal to M1 square gamma 1 square. A2 is equal to m2 square gamma 2 square. We are getting the net EMF of the cell is equal to RT by 2F log natural m2 square gamma 2 square divided by m1 square gamma 1 square. Now in general, if there are n electrons involved in the cell reaction, in that case EMF of the cell will be given by the expression E is equal to 2RT by NF log natural M2 gamma 2 divided by M1 gamma, where M representing the molality and gamma is representing the activity coefficient. Now second type is electrolyte concentration cells without transference obtained by combination of two cells. Here we are taking the two cells and then combining them in opposite direction. Now, assuming the first cell in which hydrogen electrode and silver electrode are dipped in the solution of HCl activity A1. How we are preparing these type of cells? In the first cell, we are taking hydrogen electrode and silver electrode dipped in the solution of HCl of activity A1. So the overall reaction is 1 by 2 of hydrogen plus AgCl is converting to Ag plus HCl of activity A1. In case of second cell, we are having hydrogen electrode and silver electrode dipped in the solution of HCl of activity A2. Again, we can write the overall reaction for this cell. Now, these cells has been connected to oppose each other. So we are getting a new cell which we can represent here like this, where H2 1 atmosphere in contact with the HCl solution of activity A1, silver chloride is connected to the silver electrode, and then this is connected oppositely to again similar kind of cell in which activity of HCl solution is A2. Now overall cell reaction will be obtained by subtracting second from the 1. Why we are subtracting here? As these cells has been connected in opposite to each other, so the resultant reaction will be obtained HCl of A2 moving to HCl of A1. What does it mean? 1 mole or 1 gram equivalent of HCl is moving or transferring from the solution of activity A2 to the solution of activity A1. Now in this case we are using both the term 1 mole or 1 gram equivalent. The reason being, in case of HCl, both the 1 mole or 1 gram equivalent will be same. So EMF of the first cell by applying the Nernst equation, we will get E1 is equal to E0 plus RT by F log natural 1 by A1. EMF of the second cell will be equal to E0 plus RT by F log natural 1 by A2. Now net EMF of the cell will be equal to E1 minus E2. So the resultant EMF expression is given by E is equal to RT by F log natural A2 by A1. So for 1 Faraday of passage of electricity through the cell, the overall change is only transfer of 1 mole or 1 gram equivalent of HCl acid from solution of activity A2 to the solution of activity A1. Now, what is the significance of this type of cells? We can easily determine the activity coefficient of the electrolytes by substituting the activities by the product of molalities and activity coefficients. We can get the final expression E is equal to RT by F log natural M2 square gamma 2 square divided by M1 square gamma 1 square. Now what is done to determine the activity coefficient of the electrolytes? The concentration of electrolyte of one cell is kept constant and the concentration of electrolyte in the second cell is varied. EMF of cell is measured at each concentration. We measure the EMF of cell at each concentration of the second cell. So knowing the value of gamma 1 at a particular M1, we can easily find gamma 2 at particular M2. Now, in case of concentration cell with transference, what happens? Till now we have studied concentration cells without transference. Now, in case of concentration cell with transference, the identical electrodes are immersed in two solutions of the same electrolyte having different concentration, and the two electrolytic solutions are in direct contact through a permeable partition, so that there is direct transference of electrolytes through the liquid junction. This is the main difference, basic difference between the concentration cell without transference and concentration cells with transference. Now, in this case, one thing we have to keep in mind, the EMF of the cell will result from all the processes occurring at the electrodes as well as at the liquid junction. So we will have to add the EMF arised at the liquid junction to the net electrode reaction taking place at the cell to calculate the overall EMF of the cell. So we are taking here the example of hydrogen gas electrode concentration cells with transference. In this case, hydrogen at pressure 1 atmosphere is in contact with the HCl solution of activity A1. At the other side, hydrogen at pressure 1 atmosphere is in contact with the solution of activity A2. And these two solutions are in direct contact with each other through the permeable partition, which is the liquid junction. Now, as at the left hand side, electrons are released to produce the hydrogen ion. So, there is excess of hydrogen ion which is moving from left to right through the liquid junction. Whereas, in case of right hand side, hydrogen ions are taking up electron and converting to hydrogen. So, there is excess of chloride ion on this side. So, these chloride ion will move through the liquid junction to the left hand side and they will complete the inner circuit. Now, the oxidation reaction is taking place at left hand side. So, hydrogen gas is releasing electron to convert to hydrogen ion. Similarly, reduction reaction is taking place at right hand side. So, the hydrogen ion are taking up the electron to convert to hydrogen. Now, adding both the reactions, we are getting the overall reaction. So, what is the overall reaction? There is transfer of 1 gram equivalent, or you can say 1 mole of H plus ion from the solution of activity to the solution of activity A1. We are moving 1 mole or 1 gram equivalent of hydrogen ion from the solution of activity A2 to the solution of activity A1. Now, first is the process taking place at the electrodes, which we have already discussed, and second is the process taking place at the liquid junction. So what is happening at liquid junction? The ion move freely from one solution to the other through the liquid junction. When the current is passed, hydrogen ions are generated at the left electrode and are transferred to the right electrode through the liquid junction. Chloride ions move from the right electrode to the left electrode across the liquid junction. These all things we have already discussed. Now, if T minus be the transport number of chloride ion and T plus be the transport number of hydrogen ion, we can write T plus is equal to 1 minus T minus. The reason being, the sum of transport number of cation and anion is always equal to unity. Now, For 1 Faraday of electricity passing through the cell, what will happen? T minus gram equivalent of chloride ion will be transferred from solution of activity A2 to A1. And 1 minus T minus gram equivalent of hydrogen ion will be transferred from solution of activity A1 to A2. We can represent the same thing by the equation 2 and 3. Now, overall process will be obtained by adding the electrode reaction as well as the process taking place at the liquid junction. So we will add up first, which is the electrode reaction, to second and third, and these second and third processes are taking place at liquid junction. So adding these three one, we are getting the net reaction, which is transport number T minus HCl of A2, that is moving to T minus HCl A1. So what does it mean? For 1 Faraday of electricity passing through the cell, T minus gram equivalents of HCl from the solution of activity A2 are transferred to the solution of activity A1. So overall process, what is taking place in this cell? T minus gram equivalent of HCl are moving from the solution of activity A2 to the solution of activity A1. Now again, to calculate the EMF of the cell, we are applying the Nernst equation. So we will get E is equal to minus RT by F log natural A1 raised to power T negative divided by A2 raised to power T negative. You can write it as transport number of anion. So T negative RT by F log natural A2 by A1 we can write in this way. So EMF of the cell will be equal to T negative RT by F log natural M2 square gamma 2 square divided by M1 square gamma 1 square. Again, taking the 2 on the left of this T negative, we are getting E is equal to 2 T negative RT by F log natural M2 gamma 2 divided by M1 gamma 1. So this will be the resultant EMF of the cell, which is obtained by adding the EMF arising due to the electrode reaction as well as EMF arising due to the transfer of ions through the liquid junction.